నంచున్నదే
నేను చెప్తాను,
అన్నది
మీరు కూడా నేను చెప్తాను, నలుగురికి నా గురించి నేను ఫోన్ చేసి చెప్తాను. శివానందు ఈ నలుగురికి నేను తప్పించింది.
నేను మొక్కుతా అంటే వాళ్ళకు చేయకపోతే ఎట్లా
అయితే నేను రాదు, ఒకసారి కలిసి
గంటలకు
సరే మేడం
సాయం కూడా రమ్మని చెప్పి.
మేడం శోభ మేడం బాగున్నారా?
Esteemed sister and brother judges, learned advocate general, president AP High Court Bar Association, chairman Bar Council of Andhra Pradesh, assistant solicitor general, additional advocate general, public prosecutor, law officers, learned senior advocates and members of the bar, officers of the registry, family members of late Honorable Sri Justice J. Ishwara Prasad, ladies and gentlemen. We have virtually assembled to mourn the sad demise of Honorable Sri Justice J. Ishwara Prasad, former judge of Composite High Court of Andhra Pradesh and High Court of Karnataka, who left for his heavenly abode on 6-7-2021 in the evening. Honorable Sri Justice J. Ishwara Prasad was born on 4th of August 1934, Madras, in a family of lawyers. His lordship's father, late Sri J. Sambhasivara Choudhury, was a retired district concession judge. His lordship's mother, late Srimati J. Sitama Lakshmi, was a leading lawyer of Madras and Andhra Pradesh High Courts, and was also a member of Legislative Council. His lordship graduated from Madras University and did law from Osmania University, Hyderabad. His lordship enrolled as an advocate in the year 1959 and attended the chambers of his late mother. In course of time, he developed a lucrative practice in constitutional, civil, and sales tax laws. His lordship was elevated as a judge of the High Court of Andhra Pradesh and was sworn in on 16-3-1990. Subsequently, his lordship was transferred as a judge of the Karnataka High Court and worked as such from April 1994 till his retirement in August 1996. His lordship had rendered several landmark judgments. Prior to elevation as a judge, his lordship was closely associated with many charitable and religious organizations. His lordship was also founder of Srimati Jasti Sitama Lakshmi Trust in memory of his late mother, which is carrying several charitable activities for the welfare of the society. His lordship is survived by his wife, 3 sons, 2 sons-in-law, 5 grandsons, 5 granddaughters, and 2 great-grandsons. His lordship's demise is a loss not only to the members of the family, but also a huge void which will be difficult to fill. I, on my personal behalf, and on behalf of my sister and brother judges, convey our deep condolences to the members of the bereaved family. We pay our respectful homage to the departed soul and pray to Almighty that his soul may rest in eternal peace and to bestow strength to the members of the family to bear the irreparable loss.
My Lords, the Honorable the Chief Justice, Honorable Judges, President Bar Association, Chairman Bar Council, Government Law Officers, Additional AG, ASG, Registrars of the Court, Senior Counsel, and family members of late Justice Ishwara Prasad. Truly belong to a family of many firsts, a family of lawyers, and wherefrom he had to live to the heights of excellence and other accomplishments his family members had already accomplished. In due course of time, his lordship stood testimony to all of what he had the opportunity and a blessing to learn from within the family while being a judge of the Honorable Court. A family of lawyers, especially with such accomplishments, is a standard very difficult to stand up to. And His Lordship, with His calm disposition and demeanor, and His ability to navigate difficult situations in court, truly stood testimony to how a basic training in the goodness of life would put human beings in good stead while facing situations in life. I have memories of having appeared in that court when I enrolled in the year 1992. Justice Bhaskar Rao and after him, Justice Eeshwar Prasad would be in the roster for admissions, sitting in the 11th court and thereafter in the 7th court. And we would stay through the entire day to see as to how the learned judge would deal with hundreds of matters, mostly of the service law, with many young lawyers representing the respective seniors, and His Lordship would goad the juniors to take the correct position in law. Few of us recall very fondly the interactions we had with the learned judge in the court and as to how he would be accommodative of the errors which would be made by the junior counsel. And it was a part of a growing up that all of us had the benefit of in the profession, hugely building up our confidence and also our ability to come good in a few situations. His Lordship has passed on to a world where he would be again establishing his preeminence in that world of his own now. At this sad hour, I pray Almighty to give all the courage and strength and the fortitude to the bereaved family members to bear that loss. And I pray Almighty that the departed soul may secure its place in the grand heaven of Lords.
The Honorable Chief Justice and the respected judges of this Honorable Court and the learned Advocate General, the Chairman Bar Council, the Public Prosecutor, the Assistant Solicitor General, the Law Officers of the State, the Senior Advocates and other colleague advocate friends and other staff of the High Court. We are assembled here with deep sorrow, with deep sense of sorrow, to pay homage to Justice Jasti Eeshwar Prasad, the former judge of the Composite High Court of Andhra Pradesh, who left to heavenly abode on 6th July 2021. The sudden demise of Justice Eeshwar Prasad, he has left us in deep sorrow, and the same is a huge loss to the institution. His sound contribution to the judiciary is countless and everlasting. He is a judge with great commitment, integrity and patience, and always courteous to the bar. It is hard to digest his departure from this world. Justice Eeshwar Prasad, born in 1934 in the family of advocates, and he was the second generation advocate in his family. His father worked as a district and sessions judge, and mother, late Sita Mahalakshmi, was an eminent advocate. Justice Prasad prosecuted his LLB course from Osmania University and enrolled as an advocate in the year 1959. He did his apprenticeship as a junior advocate in the chambers of his great mother, late Sita Mahalakshmi. His Lordship's wife, Srimati J. Samanti, also a famous advocate in the High Court of Andhra Pradesh. One of his sons, Mr. J.V. Prasad, is presently practicing in the High Court of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. On 16th March 1990, Justice Prasad was appointed as judge of the Composite High Court and worked in the AP High Court till April 1994, and thereafter he was transferred to Karnataka High Court, and he retired therein in August 1996. Even after his retirement, he was keenly associated with the administration of justice by accepting some other assignments. And finally, he was retired in March 2003 as Chairman of Appellate Tribunal for Forfeited Property, New Delhi. I personally know Justice Eeshwar Prasad, as I had an opportunity to appear before him in several matters. As a judge, his demeanor in the court is exemplary. He was so polite, courteous, and ever smiling. I can surely say that none of the bar members never tasted his anger at any point of time during his tenure. He leaves behind him a legacy of qualities of great jurist. His endeavor always was to enrich the young minds, to pursue the profession with excellence and commitment. During his tenure as a judge, he contributed more than 70 reported judgments, touching upon wide range of issues, including that of civil criminal service matters, constitutional issues, taxation, and many more. His knowledge of all branches of law and his intellectual exposition of principles of law, as well as his strong views in the administration of justice, were reflected in his judgments and orders. On my behalf, and also on behalf of the Advocates Fraternity, I express and place on record a deep sense of gratitude for His Lordship's contribution to the judiciary, and express my deepest condolence for his loss. It is very difficult to encompass in few words the variegated and distinguished career of Justice Eswar Prasad. His significant achievements at each important stage bring honor and glory not only to His Lordship but also to this institution. His legal acumen is exemplary, and his sudden demise is an unfilled gap to the judiciary and great loss to the institution. All that remains now is the memory of the work he did as a judge of the composite High Court. On behalf of myself, and also on behalf of the Advocates Fraternity, I extend my deepest condolences to the bereaved family members, and pray the Almighty to give strength to them to bear this unfilled loss. I pray Almighty to rest his soul in peace. Thank you all.
I will request all to observe silence for 1 minute. The court, what for the remaining day, shall remain suspended.